This is the Mazda Type GB. It's the oldest car in the museum. It's extremely rare. I think it's the only one in Europe. It's a direct descendant of the Type DA, which was Mazda's first ever motorized vehicle. And ultimately, Mazda went on to make more than 30 different types of three-wheelers.
You're a fan of the small car, aren't you, Sachin?
Looking at this, surely you'd agree, small is beautiful. This is Mazda's R360 Coupe. It's their first ever passenger car. It's under 3 meters long and has a 356cc engine. Alfred, you've driven one of these, haven't you?
Yes, the Mazda RX2. And they're really incredible. They're like nothing else you've ever driven.
The styling has a certain Italian flair to it.
Absolutely. By the 1970s, people were really being mobilized in some style. And under the hood is a rotary engine which manages to produce 120 horsepower out of just 1.2 liters.
The Mazda 626.
It's just your kind of car.
It is. I'm a big fan of 80s saloons.
You also told me your dad had one of them.
He taught me how to drive in one of these. It came with a range of engines that were specifically designed to offer performance and economy. But I think the most important thing about the 626 was it was really a saloon car designed for driving enthusiasts.
And here we've got two 323 GTs, but they're quite different from each other. This one is a 323F GT. And as you can see, in the 80s and 90s, pop-up headlights were all the rage. And this is a real beast, the 323 GTR, which had 185 horsepower.
Look at these massive air intakes and these huge fog lights.
And it really was a rally car for the road, this, wasn't it?
Yes, only 500 of these were built. It was a homologation series. It had permanent all-wheel drive and really was the most powerful Mazda 323 ever built. And well, if I'd had this when this came out, I would have been a very happy camper.
Now this is a rare one. This is a MX-5 coupe. They made around 200 of them, so they are extremely collectible.
In fact, I think you could trace the lineage of the new MX-5 RF straight back to this car.
Yeah, it really shows the strength of the MX-5 design and that it works as well as a coupe as it does as a convertible. And I've got to say that I think of all the great cars in here, this is my favorite one.